The Gospel of Luke, chapter 10, verses 38 to 42, is scripture from which we will be talking and teaching, and prayerfully you'll be blessed by this sharing. Amen? I'm reading the English Standard Version. Now, as they went on their way, Jesus entered a village, and a woman named Martha welcomed Jesus into her house. And she had a sister called Mary, who sat at the Lord's feet and listened to his teaching. But Martha was distracted with much serving. And she went up to Jesus and said, "Lord, do you not care that my sister has left me to serve alone? Tell her then to help me." But the Lord answered her, "Martha, Martha, you are anxious and troubled about many things. But one thing," somebody say one thing.
Amen.
"One thing is necessary. And Mary has chosen the good portion, which will not be taken away from her." Amen. My voice is a little raspy. I do some chaplain work for Howard Football. So I was yelling at the game like I lost my mind. So I need y'all to talk to me and to talk to each other and tell your neighbor the message of the morning. Just tell them, neighbor,
neighbor.
Oh, neighbor.
Oh, neighbor,
God needs you,
God needs you.
To focus. I am, since June, on sabbatical from New Bethel Church. So this is the first time that I've had a chance to be behind a podium in a few months. I haven't taken that kind of time away ever, because I like being busy. I like being busy. I like all the productivity apps on my phone. I like that stuff. I mean, all of the YouTube productivity wonks and gurus, I watch them all. Because I want to be at tip-top productivity. And I want to be efficient with it. So I want to make sure I got all the tools and the toys. Never mind that I don't know how to use them that well. I just like having them. I got a phone. I got not one iPad, I got two iPads. I got an iMac. I got a MacBook Pro. Two to be exact. And it makes me feel like I'm able to accomplish more when I got all these things. Because I told you, I like being busy. But can I suggest to you that it's dangerous to be busy? When you're too busy, You can miss some of the things you need to be paying attention to. In fact, since I'm feeling like family now, can I be honest enough and confess and admit to you that I have a problem? 'Cause when I'm in my car, while driving, I'm often more engaged with my device than I need to be. And sometimes I text. What? I know you, I, Me and Siri got a relationship. But it can be distracting. And you know, distractions can kill you. Not only can they kill you driving, but distractions can suck life out of you. They can take you off course. They can make you miss opportunities. They can make you waste time. They can make you discount the people that God sent to bless you and give a whole lot more account to folk that wear nice clothes, live in nice places, but really ain't the ones that are for you. Perhaps worst of all, distractions can make you miss Jesus. And so here is Jesus in town, and he's coming to Martha's house, and he's gathered in the place, but Jesus is there for relationship reasons, not to be transactional. Jesus is there because he's concerned to make sure that people that he loves get what they need to get. Because Jesus is relational. Jesus is far more interested in relationship than he is in checking boxes. Which means Jesus ain't giving you credit just because you got up and came to church. Jesus ain't interested in all the boards you serve on. Jesus ain't interested in your reputation among the people. What Jesus wants to know is, do you care and connect with him? And so here is Jesus at Martha's house. Martha is Mary's sister. Mary is sitting at Jesus' feet. And Martha is checking on the cornbread and the greens and the mac and cheese and all the things that you do when people come to your house. She's trying to listen to Jesus, but she's distracted. She's distracted by all of the things that you're really supposed to do when people come to your house. So she's missing all of the gems that Jesus is dropping on Mary. Because Martha is concerned about other stuff. And it upsets her so much so that she steps to Jesus. I'm in the text. Jesus, don't you care that my sister got me doing all the work by myself? Don't you know what it takes to make corn pudding and potato salad and greens and string beans and tomatoes? Greens, beans, tomatoes. And I want to, have you ever been asked a question that's not really a question, but a point that somebody is trying to make in the form of a question? This is how Martha steps at Jesus. She ain't really looking for Jesus to give her revelation. She's trying to give Jesus her revelation. And Jesus says, Martha, you missed it. You gone left. You're majoring in minors. Don't you know I come from the place and am of the person who can speak and things coming to existence? You missed it. You're concerned about a whole lot of stuff that you don't need to be concerned about. What I need, Martha, here's what Jesus says. So I need you to get. Martha, I need for you to focus. focus. Because life gets too chaotic for you not to be intentional about relationship with Jesus. So I told you I'm gonna be personal with you. I lost my mom in March. And grief is a real thing. Oh gosh, I wish I had more time. Please don't feel guilty because you're grieving. This is for somebody who's lost something. It might be a loved one, but it might be a job. It might be a child that's gone off to school. Grief is a real thing. And so I'm going through this season, and I ended up taking a sabbatical. And in the middle of the sabbatical, right? Matter of fact, right in the beginning of the sabbatical, I hear God say, "So now what you gonna do?" Because I'm so busy moving and being busy. I'm busy being busy. And yet God has a way of shutting things down. Anybody ever had God shut things down? Just shuts everything down. Because sometimes that's the only way that you'll listen to God. Is if he shuts stuff down. And this is where I found myself in the sabbatical. And he's done it so that I can hear him. So that I can focus on him. Because the question is, how are you to hear Jesus, see Jesus, be moved by Jesus in the midst of all of the chaos? The answer is this: you must learn to course correct when necessary and focus. And focus. Because here's the first point right here. What you do will never be as important as who you are. What you do will never be as significant as who you are. Matter of fact, truth of the matter is that what you do grows out of who you are. So that's the reason why you act the way you act when folk cut you off in traffic. Because I know you saved, but that's who you are. That's the reason why right now you planning on how you gonna come for somebody on your job before they come for you. Because you in church right now. But me with my Southeast self, that's who I am. Martha is doing her best to follow Jesus. But she is a doer by nature. And she's busy doing, thinking that her doing is going to gain her favor with God. And so when the stress of the moment hits, what's in her comes out. Because you might be able to fool some of the people some of the time. But when life hits, who you are will come out. Stop asking yourself why you did that. It's because who you are will come out. And so at some point, you are going to have to get in a position where you are willing to course correct and focus. Because the problem is that Martha is so consumed with her doing, and Jesus is concerned about her being. This is what happens to many of us. We're so concerned with doing that we give little concern to what we should be, who God has made us to be. We become like a dog chasing its tail, moving nowhere, getting nothing done. And so caught up in the stuff. Can I talk to the church folk for a minute? So caught up in the stuff of church and religion that we miss the stuff of Jesus. So you're busy but not productive. Your calendar is full, but you ain't moving forward. Got lots of things on your to-do list, but you ain't growing. No guidance from the master, just busy. No purpose or meaning, just busy. No goals of glory, just busy. And I've learned that you can be so busy doing that you don't even know why you're doing it. This is how you get to a place where politics becomes more important than people. This is how you get to a place where religion is more important than relationship. What you do will never be as important as who you are. And so the question is, are you willing to shift your attention from all of the things on your list and give it to the source? There are some things that you are responsible for, but can I just let you know that you'll be a lot more effective in a lot less time if you check in with the one who's given you the assignment? Yes, you're gifted. Yes, you're called. Yes, you're anointed. But you're going to be a whole lot more effective in your calling and with your anointing and in your assignment if you give attention to the one who gave you the assignment. So can I tell you how I got through school? Here's how I got through school. I got a few degrees and all that. The process has always been the same. Get close to the teacher. Get close to the teacher, because the teacher is looking for those who are so serious about their course that they'll spend time with you when they haven't spent it with the rest of the class. They'll pour into you when you humble yourself and make yourself available to them. God sent me to tell you today, get close to the teacher. He'll pour into you. He'll give you insight. He'll give you wisdom. He'll give you understanding. He'll say, no, talk to this person, not that person. No, next time, talk to that person, not this person. Go left at the intersection, not right at the intersection. Get close to the teacher. Hebrews says it this way: fix your eyes on Jesus, who is the author and the finisher of your faith, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despising shame, and is now seated on the right hand of the Father. Wait a minute before you shout. Making intercession for you and for me. That shouts me. I'm sorry. I get excited at the fact that Jesus is seated at the right hand as my intercessor. He speaks for me. He protects me. He provides for me. He delivers me. Makes ways for me, opens doors. And there's nothing that you can do to make God stop loving you. There's nothing you can say to make God turn his back on you. It ain't about what you do. It's about what he's done and about who he is. Is there anybody in the house that can celebrate the fact that you have a God who loves you not because of you, but loves you in spite of you. With my foolish ways, he loves me. With my attitude, he loves me. Because what you do will never be more important than who you are. So you need a focus, a faith focus. Here's the second thing. I gotta hurry up. Y'all get me excited up in here. Second thing, that you need to focus on Jesus. Because the demands of life will always be greater than you can handle by yourself. I know this ain't gonna excite somebody, because really, if you get excited in this part of the message, you're gonna think that somebody thinks that you ain't got what you need. You ain't got the tools. You ain't got the game to be who you are. Can I give you theological revelation? You ain't who you try to be. You really ain't. All it is that you try to make everybody else think that you are. Martha says it herself. Jesus, don't you see? I can't do all of this by myself. Y'all think that she's just talking about making the meal, but there's something that goes beyond that. Don't you see that I can't handle this responsibility all by myself? Now we throw shade at Martha because she ain't in the place that she should be, and she's not. But you gotta at least give her credit for seeking to get beyond the Lone Ranger syndrome. Okay, so I'm gonna date myself a little bit. Some of y'all know something about the Lone Ranger. So some of us a little bit too young. Lone Ranger, who fought all the outlaws. The way that the Lone Ranger got his name is that he was part of a group of six Rangers. And they went in to do a conquest, and they were ambushed by a gang. The only one that survived the ambush was the Lone Ranger. Stay with me. Lone Ranger was saved by a character named Tonto. Tonto was a Native American. And he gave Lone Ranger his name. So while everybody celebrates Lone Ranger, he actually is named by one who is minimized. Everybody wants to celebrate Lone Ranger. But can I tell you, it's one who was lowly who gave Lone Ranger his name. It's one who's lonely, who saved Lone Ranger. And I know that there's some folk who talk about Jesus being soft. Some folk who talk about Jesus not having anything. But can I just tell you that the King of Kings is one who came and didn't have a place to lay his head. The King of Kings is one who was born in a manger. And he gave you your name. You're called Christian because of Christ. He gave you your name. So what makes you think that you can do anything without the one who gave you your identity? You are a child of God. an heir and joint heir with Jesus Christ. And if you give him some time and some space, he'll do what no other power can do. We used to sing a song that says, God specializes. Have you any rivers that you think are impossible? Have you any valleys that you cannot tunnel through? God specializes. And I've learned that Jesus still works miracles. Is there anybody in the house that knows? He still saves. He still delivers. He still picks you up. He still forgives me. He still loves you when you don't love yourself. And so I'm convinced that if Martha had given Jesus time and space, that he would have given to her what she couldn't get for herself. And Martha got the nerve to get mad when everybody else ain't busy and stressed and anxious like her. Because when your mind ain't right, it causes you to go into spaces and do things that are out of alignment with your identity. It can cause you to make you want to throw in the towel. It can cause you to want to take your own life. It can cause you to want to quit. It can cause you to want to leave. It makes you wonder why you should pray when ain't nothing happening. It makes you want to stop coming to church because ain't making no difference. But hear me when I tell you. Tell somebody, listen to this. If you focus on Jesus, spend time with Jesus, give praise to Jesus, and let his word do its work on your mind, your focus will shift. Let this mind be in you that was also in Christ Jesus. Because when your mind is right, your focus will be right. When your focus is right, your worship will be right. When you worship right, God shows up. I need to give it to somebody else who wants to tweet it. When your mind is right, your focus is right. When your focus is right, your worship is right. When your worship is right, God shows up. I said, when your mind is right, your focus gets right. When your focus gets right, your worship gets right. When your worship is right, God shows up. One last time for myself. When your mind is right, your focus is right. When your focus is right, your worship is right. When your worship is right, that's why you saw them singing like that. They might not even feel like it, but they know that when worship is right and the house is right, God shows up. And when God shows up, healing happens, deliverance happens, salvation happens, doors open. Is there anybody in the house that believes on the first Sunday in September, God has shown up? So I'm gonna give him worship because he showed up. I'm gonna give him praise because he showed up. I'm gonna bless his name. God, I got so much I want to say. This is why testimony is important, y'all. Martha may have forgotten who she is. She's a daughter of the king. But not only that, she's a friend of Mary and Lazarus. Okay, you missed it. Lazarus is the one that Jesus raises from the dead. Jesus wasn't the only one that got up from the grave. Lazarus got out of the grave. And Martha is connected to Lazarus. So God makes no differentiation or distinction between Mary, Martha, Lazarus, and you. That means if you're in a dead situation, life is heavy, you can't handle it. We have a God who is able to bring dead stuff back to life. Turn situations around. In the church, we said it this way: He'll pick me up, turn me around, plant my feet on. So look, I need y'all to know, I need y'all to get this. What you do will never be as important as who you are. Never be as important as who you are. Life will get so heavy that you can't handle it by yourself. But you don't have to handle it by yourself. This Messiah syndrome that you got will take you to your grave. Sometimes you need to pray that word, one word prayer. Help! Father, I stretch my hands to thee. I thought this was a church crowd. No other help but. So, what you do will never be as important as who you are. There'll be times when life gets too heavy for you to handle by yourself. But here's the last reason that you got to focus on Jesus. It's so that you will realize and recognize and maximize your moment. Whatever Martha needs is connected to Jesus. There is nothing that Martha will ever need that Jesus can't do for her. This was her moment. This is her chance. And if she'll only give him undivided attention, he'll stretch her capacity so that she can do more, see more, understand more than she could ever do by herself. So, this message is personal for me. Because I'm the kid who used to love the circus. The three-ring circus. I loved it, but I hated it at the same time. Because I never knew which ring to watch. You got the clowns getting out the car on this side. You got the elephants doing their tricks on this in the middle. You got the lions and tigers and bears, oh my. And I never knew which ring to watch. But I learned that there was one ring that was most important. It was the one that had the ring master. And as long as I focused on the ring master, I wouldn't miss the moment. Because the ring master would guide my attention. And so I've decided, Grace, that I'm gonna focus on the ring master. Because the ringmaster is the author and the finisher of our faith. The ringmaster is the one who heals my ailments and cures my addictions. The ringmaster is the one who still does miracles, and he's doing it all again. The ringmaster is the one who owns the cattle upon a thousand hills. The ringmaster is the one who, when I'm weak, he'll make me strong. The ringmaster is the one who'll be a friend when I have no friends. The ringmaster is the one who'll never leave me or forsake me. The ringmaster is the one who's a way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. So ask the Savior to help you. Comfort, strengthen, and keep you. I'm just an old Baptist kid. He's willing to aid you. I'm done. I'm done. Listen, y'all come on, we're done. Jesus says, there ain't but one thing that you need to be focused on. Some say focus stands for follow one course until successful. Follow one course until successful. It's a good acronym for you to apply to your life as it relates to all your endeavors and all the things you're trying to accomplish. But can I tell you, there's something that is higher than that. Because Jesus says there's one thing. One thing. And he's the one thing. And so this invitation is for somebody who's been focused on a lot of things. Distracted by a lot of things. Gotten carried away by a lot of noise. He wants you to know that there ain't but one that's died for you. There ain't but one who has gotten up from the grave on his own volition. Ain't but one who's ascended and is coming back. Ain't but one who's given his spirit that becomes alive and active if you will focus. So as is the way that's done here at Grace, I'm going to invite you, if you need focus on that one thing, you've never given attention to Jesus before. He's been an alternative, but he hasn't been the focus. And today you're ready to make a decision, make him your focus. Can I invite you to just raise your hand? You want to make him your focus. Praise God for the hands that are lifted. You want to make him your focus. Maybe you want to rededicate your life today. Like something happened along the way that caused you to lose focus. My wife was watching the movie last night, and there was a loud sound on the movie, and it caused her to shift. It got her attention. Sometimes the things that you are dealing with in your life are God's way of getting your attention. And you need to make a decision today to refocus. If you want to rededicate your life, maybe you have relationship with Jesus, had relationship with Jesus, but you need to refocus. Can I invite you to raise your hand?
I'm so glad you joined me for this special teaching of God's Word. It's my sincere prayer that you learn something new about God that changed your life forever. Please be sure to subscribe to this YouTube channel and hit the bell for our new content. And we upload new stuff every week. Also, it's with the help of folks like yourself that we can bring the teaching of God's Word to people around the DMV as well as around the world. So simply put, we cannot do it alone. So please take a moment to partner with us to help bring this life-changing gospel to even more people. Getting started is easy. Just go to gracechurchva.org/give. And as always, thank you for your support and thank you for helping us advance the kingdom of God.